Hey there. You know those beautiful pictures with blurred backgrounds and magical balls of light? Those are called bokeh balls. You can do some fancy camera work to create this effect right in your camera. Or you can do it the sneaky way and apply this effect to any of your images right inside of Affinity Photo. Let's get started. All right. We're going to go ahead and get started with this portrait of a woman, and we also need a bokeh ball background to put on top of this image to create our effect. So down in the video description, I've linked this portrait and four different bokeh ball backgrounds that you can choose from. And for this example today, we're going to use the pink bokeh background. So on this pink bokeh background tab, I'm going to go ahead and press Command or Control C. Then we're going to go back over to the Portrait tab and press Command or Control V. Well, we can't see the woman anymore. That's not going to work. So we're going to go ahead and change the blend mode. So go over and change the blend mode from Normal to Screen. Screen is an awesome blend mode because it takes away all the dark parts from your photo and just leaves all the light parts. So in this case, we can see the bokeh balls, but none of that dark purple background. Back in our image, we're going to go ahead and press V for our move tool. Now we can go ahead and resize this bokeh ball background however we like. And then I'm going to press Command or Control 0 to zoom back out. I mean, zoom back in. You know what I mean. If we wanted to, at any time, we could also right-click on the image, go down to Transform, and we can flip it horizontally or vertically. Now, I don't really like how that looks, so I'm going to press Command or Control Z to undo that, but feel free to do it how you want. So now we can see, with our image looking great, the positioning looks awesome, the colors don't look right. But don't worry, we're going to do a couple of adjustments and fix that right up. So, go down to your adjustments icon, and we're going to click on Recolor. This recolor adjustment is affecting all of the colors in our image, but we just want it to affect the bokeh ball background. So I'm going to click and drag the recolor adjustment down and to the right of the bokeh ball layer. Now I can adjust the hue and the saturation however I want. So I'm going to bring the hue to about 35 to create that golden glow, but I'm thinking that it's looking a little too saturated, so I'm going to bring that down to around 60. Well, that first adjustment just made a huge difference. I'm really liking how this is looking. Now we're going to go ahead and press the adjustment icon one more time and apply a levels adjustment. Thankfully, the levels adjustment was applied as a child layer to our bokeh ball layer, but if for some reason it's above it, you can just drag it down and to the right of the bokeh ball layer as well. The levels adjustment has a black level slider, and what this slider does is as you bring it up, it removes haziness from our image, but it also gets rid of our bokeh balls. So I'm going to bring it to around 10% so we get a little more sharpness, but we don't lose the bokeh balls. With our two adjustments applied and looking great, we're going to go ahead and press on the bokeh ball main layer, and we're going to apply a mask to it. So go down and hit the mask icon, and then press on the mask icon within the layer studio. And now we're going to paint out some of the bokeh ball layer on the woman's face. So, go to your colors and make sure that you're painting in black. Press B for your brush tool. And now up in the context toolbar, we're going to make sure our hardness is set to 0%. And let's bring down the flow to about 10%. So now we can go ahead and zoom in and remove it from her face. Now, I know right now it doesn't look like I'm doing anything at all, but trust me, in a second I'll show you. This actually does make a difference. So I'm going to zoom out by pressing Command or Control 0. And now we can turn this mask on and off to see the difference. So here's the before, and here's the after. I think this just adds a little bit of clarity to her face, darkens the eyes, and really makes her face stand out. So now we can see our before and our after of this bokeh ball effect. One last tip for you. If you feel like this effect is a little bit too strong, you can always lower the opacity of the bokeh ball layer. You can also experiment with our other bokeh ball backgrounds that we have linked below. And if you want to keep becoming a photo editing master, you can check out this video on how to edit like Brandon Wolfel. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.